After making a cardboard cut design, so to speak, I was happy that the position, it was good. I already cut it in places. What I should have done is obviously film the whole thing, but you can probably imagine. So it fitted in there perfect. So I had to cut it in two parts because I thought that this would be a lot easier to weld. So what I did is, this tank is done. It's not the prettiest in places, you know, still learning, even though it says Rusky Weld fabulous. It's not very fabulous, but it's okay, you know, it's all right. I'm pretty sure it's not gonna leak. So this is one part, and now I'm gonna make this part, and this part is literally gonna weld to the side. So I'll weld all three sides, and then it will weld like that, because this one needed to be watertight. This one, on the other hand, doesn't need to be watertight. Well, it kind of does need to be watertight, but it will be easy. So then, yeah, we'll just weld this, make a cover, Bosch, couple of sort of intakes, and we're done with this one.
3:28 a.m.
Until wee hours in the morning, I spend doing this, and it should fit something like this. Yeah, a couple of tabs to hold it in place, and I think it'll be good. It'll be integrated washer bottle in a sort of original location of my old expansion bottle, and also a catch tank, and by my calculations it should be over 2 liters. So that is fantastic. So all this thing needs now is a cover like this. Difficult to do it with one hand, but hold on. So a cover like this, and also two of those. One for the catch tank, somewhere here, like this. And this one will probably be here. I'm still not sure in the position. First, I'll need to put the tabs, fix it in there, put the scaffold panel thing on, and then this will weld onto there. Obviously, a couple of ports, you need drain. Obviously, you need drain. So I have one of those bangs, and I've seen people use them. So this will go right here in a corner, something like this. So when it sits in the car, there's a clear access to this from the wheel arch, and I'll be able to put a tube if I need to drain it, open the valve. And this is a proper, like a gas valve, so it's not one of those cheap ones. And then this motor, it's a generic something, I don't know, Citroen, Peugeot, whatever they use. This will go into here, and it will seat like this. Yeah, nice, small, and neat. Well, it's ready, guys. Would you like to see it? Secretly, I'm very proud of this. I mean, I've never done anything as elaborate as this. And I have to admit, it didn't take me that long. So I started about, 10 o'clock last night, finished at 1, went to bed. And today from 10, I mean, it's been sitting out and now I kind of, I'm filming it a bit later on. But yeah, overall about 6 hours maybe. Yeah, very happy how it turned out. If you're asking, is it 2 liters? Yes, it is. It's 2.25 or something like that. I did check. So what do we have? We have a pump. We have 2 compartments. The one closer to me is a washer bottle. This one is the thing. One thing is missing, and I ran out of AN10 fittings, weld-on fittings. It will be here, right in front of me, where you can see I'm obviously holding it with one hand. Actually, you know what? I can show you like that. I'll have to put another fitting here, because on the K24, apparently there's 2 ports that sort of do the breather thing. I only thought it was one. So we have one here coming from the T7 water plate kit. And then there is not going to be another one here going from the top of the block. So I'll just weld it. Hopefully it will show up tomorrow. It's quick, just literally weld it. I was thinking of painting it the same color as the car, but I quite like the aluminium. And this is the port, the exit port. This is AN8, and it's gonna go into the intake before the turbo, as recommended by Nick Prawn, Nigel Pindewagen, many people basically saying that's the best way, because obviously, you know, the cheaper way and the sort of BOGO way is to just vent it to atmosphere or just run the tube under the car or whatever. That is not correct. On the previous one, it was sort of all part of the sort of dry sump system, so it had all the baffles and obviously all the oil was returning back into the sort of oil tank and all of that stuff. And we have a drain. Some people run it back into the sump. I don't like that idea. I would rather it to collect and then I can drain it. I can just literally put a hose and I can drain it ball valve. And also this thing is gonna be filled. It will be filled with this, a marvel of Chinese engineering. Those are stainless steel scousers. I've used it before and it works really, really well. So instead of doing baffles inside of the tank, you basically fill it with this material fully, and yeah, it basically acts as a baffle. Again, I read it on the internet, so it has to be true, right? Would you like to see how it fits? Ta-da! So yeah, it sits in here, away from the turbo, away from everything. You have a hose running to the inlet. Inlet is going to be somewhere here. And then obviously that one runs at the top around the engine from that side. And from here it will run to the front. So yeah, as you can see, it's quite neat, isn't it? I'm very happy. One thing I didn't do, and I was kind of like, should I not? Basically the filler. I was thinking of doing the filler from the old hole, but then it just becomes so ugly and so long. And in all honesty, how often am I going to fill the bottle? Probably not very often. And even if I need to do it, all you do is you open the bonnet and then you just sort of move this out of the way. And I know this will definitely move out of the way, and then you fill it. It's not ideal, but it's good enough. Anyways, guys, thank you very much for watching. I'm not sure how this video sort of turned out, but yeah, another big job ticked off the list. Running out of time, but I said that before. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video. Also, air fresheners, they're amazing. Buy one. See you on the next one. Bye bye.
Let's find out.
This is 4 pints, so it's 2.2 liters. Two 75. and it wasn't full. So yeah, this is more than 2 liters.